let's talk about variables. Variables are a fundamental concept in computer science. So what are they? Let's say you're helping your parents move out of their home. The thing is, they haven't bothered packing anything yet. They want you to do it for them because they finally think you're useful for once. As you're packing, you can think of the boxes as variables. You can put anything you want inside and replace it later with something of the same category. Then, you would label it so you know what that box is being used for later on. That way, when Mom asks you where the pictures of her favorite son are, you know what box has the pictures of your brother. A variable works the same way as this metaphor. They're storage locations with assigned names that hold data that you can use and change later on. Like a box, variables can hold a whole variety of categories. In programming, these things would be known as data types. A variable's data type determines the type of data that it can hold. Hence the name data type. For example, the language Java has many different data types, including integer, character, byte, strings, short, long, boolean, double, and float. We won't go into detail of exactly what these data types do here, but we'll talk about them in another video. Now let's go ahead and see how we write a variable. Before using a variable, you gotta create it. Creating a variable is known as declaring a variable. When coding a variable, you'll generally first declare its data type, then its name, then assign it a value. First, you declare the variable's data type to determine what you want to store in this variable. Maybe you want to make it store a number or even a word.
But remember,
you can only store values of that variable's data type, so don't go storing words inside of integer boxes. Also, you only need to specify a variable's data type the first time you declare it, so you don't need to state that your variable is an integer or a string every time you want to reuse it. Next, you would give your variable a name. When giving your variables names, it's important that you name them something meaningful, rather than something undescriptive or random. It's like if you were baking a cake and had three jars labeled X, Y, and Z. You wouldn't know which one's your flour, which one's your sugar, and which one's grandma's ashes. Mixing up your variable names, or in this case, jars, could lead to many issues. Or grandma-flavored cake. So using meaningful names will help you easily identify the use of that variable later on in your program. After giving it a name, you could then assign it a value.
Do we have to assign it a value?
No, Kevin. If you want, you can declare your variable without a value. It would just be an empty box in that case. Once you declare a variable, there are a lot of ways to use it.
Can we see some examples?
Sure thing, Kevin. Here are a couple examples of how to use them. One thing you can do is change or override values. We'll start with a basic example. Here, we have a variable named score with an integer data type, meaning it can only hold whole numbers. We'll assign it with a value of 10. We then call the variable to replace its original value of 10 with a new value of 3. And that's it. Now score has a value of 3. Here's a similar example, but with words. We have a variable named greeting, and it holds the word hi. Then, we can replace that greeting with the word howdy. Here's a more complex example with two variables. We have a variable named total that's been declared without a value, and we have a variable named points with a value of 3. Now, we want to assign total a new value of our points variable plus 5. So total is basically 3 plus 5. And now our variable total has a new value of 8. And that's it. This is what variables are in a nutshell. We hope you've learned something, and if you like this video, please like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you'll know when our next video comes out. Also, let us know of any topics that you would like us to cover next time. And we'll see you again in the next one. Say bye, Kevin.
Bye.